is ABC 7 News at 11.
So we'll have to get through the fun.
Hi!
Okay.
We're on.
We're on.
Yeah.
Okay.
So.
Now, if you have a tight living or workspace, it can be difficult to find the best way to utilize limited space.
So designers have to deal with this issue all the time. No big deal for them, but they do have a few tricks to maximize the space's potential, and we're helping all of us cheat today. Mary Cook is one of those designers, and she's with us today to share a few suggestions. Welcome.
Thank you.
Nice to see you.
Okay,
nice
so the biggest secret you say is always start with design projects with your 7 fundamentals of design, which are?
The 7 fundamentals start with function and livability.
Uh-huh.
Scale and proportion,
okay. Uh-huh.
Light and lighting, color, pattern, significant and relevant ornament, and a deep understanding of your demographic and geographic influences.
Okay, so if you have a designer, they can explain what all that means to you, right?
Right. Exactly.
You know?
But if we look at those 7 fundamentals, it'll help us no matter what size of space.
No matter what size, no matter what style.
Okay.
So yeah, okay, I understand function and proportion. I would think those are very, very important to make everything that you put into the small space functional.
Definitely.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Definitely.
All right. All right. Let's look at some examples. We have picture. Okay. This is the before of a small room, right?
Mm-hmm.
And this room is going to have to do what?
It's got to do double duty. It's both living and dining room. It's a loft style of space,
uh-huh.
And so we need it to multitask. We need it to serve both dining and entertaining and living. So one of my favorite things about this space is the piece that we're sitting in. It mm-hmm. makes it all work, and that we're able to put dining tight up against the wall.
Oh, that's right. Is it off to the right
it's
of
to
us?
The right.
Off to the right.
Right.
Uh-huh.
Okay.
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 And
nice.
You then can pull several chairs up around
right.
and accommodate dining for 6, 8,
yes.
however many. Mm-hmm. And then if you want it to serve for entertaining afterwards, you can push the table. It slides right in between the bookcases. Pull this out from behind it. And pull it up to the living area. Add a couple of great decorative patterned mm-hmm. pillows to it, and it.
Oh, that's what you mean by
this.
It
shows
this couch.
Because this couch, how big is this couch?
This couch is a perfect scale.
Mm-hmm.
It
yeah.
is just 78 inches wide.
Okay. Right.
But
yeah.
it's got a standard seat height, so
mm-hmm.
it's going to work with your 30-inch high table.
Right.
It's got a little bit higher back, which, when it's up against the wall, will
yes.
ground the stuff above it. It's the perfect piece, and it has no
nice.
Arms, so your guests can slip in and out very
nice.
Easily.
Okay,
okay.
Yeah. function,
right?
Right. Okay,
function, right. Yeah.
So let's move to this one now.
Next, this is are we dealing with?
Do we have a picture of this? No, this is
we
for,
do.
This is for
bedroom.
A bedroom
okay.
space.
This is so in super small spaces, mostly studios. You're going to have living as very much a part of your entertaining area.
Yeah.
So when you have to have the bed or sleeping integrated right there with living, the best way to do that is to make super tailored bedding and just really richen it up. So
okay.
I brought a couple of selections here. We've got a great scale pattern to start with. We've got a smaller scale pattern here. A very geometric stripe, which
mm-hmm.
could also be a plaid. And then we contrast it with great cream linen to sharpen it up, and it really becomes a very dimensional space.
So it's about the tailored look. It all blends in nicely, and the bed's not screaming at you, hey, I'm a bed over
exactly,
here.
Exactly.
Very nice.
Right.
Yeah.
Right.
Okay.
So now, for this, for entertainment?
This is one of my favorite pieces.
Yeah, let's
the before.
Go back here.
Here's
yeah,
our before. This looks
here.
Really small, this before picture.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
This is a corner of a space
uh-huh.
that we're going to grab as a tech niche and use for work-at-home area, a work-at-home space. And so during the day when we're working, this might have laptop and all sorts of papers and so forth on it. But at night, this adjusts in height. It raises and lowers, which makes it great with just four simple screws. And now we can pull this away from the wall, clear off all the tech stuff, and set it up as a bar cart.
I love
bar.
That.
So from a desk? You come up a little bit.
Exactly.
Great
exactly.
idea.
Okay,
very
good
idea.
Ideas.
And you didn't spend a ton of money to be able to do all of this.
No, this is Bassett Furnitures, and it's under $400.
Excellent.
It's a great, great piece.
We like
we
that
love
even
it.
Better. Okay.
Yes,
great.
Exactly.
Thank you so
right,
much
Mary,
for coming
thanks
in.
Thanks very much. For a recap of Mary's design fundamentals and where you can find these space-saving solutions mm-hmm. and how to contact Mary, too, go to abc7chicago.com. Thanks very much. We'll be right back.